Hey. Ladies and gentlemen, Mr. Ben Grunfeld. Mr. Ben Grunfeld.
A little bit earlier, and this is a very important thing to anyone who has kids who want to play music and want to give them some advice, and that is, do not be an asshole. Because everyone will remember an asshole, and the only reason why I've gotten to play with the bands I played is because I've never been a drunk asshole. I focus on the job that I do, I want to do it as good as I can, and I've seen so many musicians I've shared the stage with, there's always an asshole. Louder than everyone else, plays over everybody else, don't learn the songs. So I was asked in 97, after I left Leningrad Cowboys, we did a support tour for Wishbone Ash with a band that I was playing called Guitar Slingers. And we got on really great. I did sound check quickly, not trying to be in their way. And you know, it was the first guys who came and said, hey, it's nice working with you. Where's the crew? And and then later on I suddenly realized, oh, beside the stage is standing Andy Powell. And he was like, cool man. And I went up and said, thanks for having us. And within a month after the tour, I got a call saying that, would you like to come and play? We have a Wishbone Ash fan convention in England. We'd like to invite your band over, my trio. And I went and he said, yeah, we liked your playing and you're a nice guy. And that went on. I was in America, in England, supporting them. And I booked a gig for them in Finland, my band supporting. And that was maybe January 2000. And in February 2000, I got a call from Andy Powell. I was lying on the couch. I had fever. I was sick. And I was reading a book about Wishbone Ash. What is it? In 97, they had a support band called Guitar Slingers, and Andy was very impressed with the guitar player, Ben Graf. And then, bling. Hello, here's Andy Powell, aus America. Would you like to join Wishbone Ash? And yeah. And then the phone rang again. And I was at the point where I had just done a tour with Lynyrd Skynyrd and with Thin Lizzy in Germany, and I had a record contract that I was about to sign. And then I thought, nein, scheiße. I called my record label, the guys in my band, and said, look, I just got a call from Andy Powell to join Wishbone Ash. I think I should do this. And they said, of course you do it. But it was the best choice ever made. Before this, being in a professional band was always maximum 2 weeks on the road. Or in Finland, as we say, we go on tour in Finland, it's from Thursday till Saturday. And then Sunday, Monday, you have hangover, and then Tuesday, Wednesday, when can we go on tour again? But with Wishbone Ash, it was hard work, and those who know Wishbone Ash music, it's not simple music to play. There was a lot of work to learn. But we play, we'd go on for 5 or 6 weeks, Mondays were off, otherwise we'd play every day. I mean, I think I got a lot of chops from playing live a lot. The only way you can really learn to play or sing is by standing on stage. I mean, we can stand in front the mirror in our bedroom, but it doesn't help, because the only one staring back is you. So, yeah, Wishbone Ash was incredibly important, and I learned a lot, and I really enjoyed it. But after 4 years, I realized that there's something bigger in me that wants to be poorer.
Wanted to be your own thing.
Solo artist.
Yes, that.
Said, boy, you will not last. who knows what might appear. I need to find me a reason. I need something to believe in. Something that can save me. We'll be right back.
to look my father's grave. The devil slipped her from behind the tombstone and he said, ashes to ashes, dust to dust. Well, life's your business and the rip reaper gets you fast. Well, right, I said, let's go for both the girls on my farm. I gotta have it all right now before I'm down.
For instance, the title track, My Soul to You, is something that I thought, you know, would be kind of a Mark Knopfler-y thing and would not suit on my album. And he said, stop, what was that? And he said, that's a great song, yeah, but it doesn't have a chorus, but that's the chorus. And it was just a simple riff. And he said, you sing the same melody. Okay, can you do that? And most of the songs were born very quickly. And, you know, there's no rule for songwriting. Sometimes it just happens. And sometimes you have ideas that last, like the first song on the album is called Weight of the World. And I had the title and the idea for the lyrics about how terrible we are in this der Welt. And the riff was also old, and then I was playing it and I made a mistake. I started riffing and I played the wrong chord. And I figured, wait a minute, this is great. Now I can go to a chorus. And, you know, after 5 years of struggling with that riff. Waiting, yeah. And, I mean, the music was recorded live in 2 days, and then I spent some 4 or 5 days singing. Then I lost my voice, as now. And I got very sick. I had bronchitis, and I was... Then I the Christmas I was in bed, then I got pneumonia, and we finished the album in mid-January, that's why it's a bit late. But
you totally recovered?
Yes. I recovered and now I'm sick again. But, you know, I said that there should not be, you know, a rule that if you are a certain artist, you can only play one style. There is stuff that is very bluesy, there's stuff that's very melodic, there's one or two tracks that are a little bit harder or more heavier, but you've heard the album and I like to combine everything. I don't want to be just one style. Yeah. That's why I'm wearing black and white clothes.
Two different styles.
Yes, black and white.
Yeah, so you're on tour Germany now and coming back, I think you said, probably this fall as well.
Yeah, September I have a little bit longer tour and the album comes out 15th of June, so there's a little bit of promotion before that, and then in September we tour for 4 weeks, starting 14th of September in Hamburg, Downtown Blues Club, and I think the last gig is 6th of October, somewhere in Germany. My mother always calls me, where are you now? In Germany, what town? And I look at the itinerary, Gelsenkirchenhofenslauf. And she goes, where is that? In Germany.
sad. Maybe will you ever be? Son of a gun.
Guten Abend.
This is water with goose pimples.
Schade.
Do you want to have a quiet water or a loud water? Or
this is fine for
this
now.
Fine this for is fine for you. Okay, good, not good. Good.
So Ben, do they teach German at schools in Finland?
Jawohl, ich habe für 5 Jahre Deutsch gelernt und alles vergessen.
Er kann aber Tante Hilde sein.
Ja, der Tante Hildegard hat keine Brille. Oder um die Ecke ist ein Kamel.
Das ist auch schön.
Treffpunkt am Autobahn. But that doesn't help when I sit in a Kneipe.
Ja,
das ist doch schon eine Menge Deutsch.
Das ist ja.
Ja, aber I don't understand everything.
Ja, du kannst wissen, ein bisschen Deutsch.
Ja.
I cannot speak Finnish.
Ei se mitään, mä voin tolkata, jos sä haluat katsoa koko
kilpailun. Haben wir nicht gelernt in der
you
Schule.
You can one word, you say, Kimi Räikkönen.
Kimi Räikkönen.
Kimi Räikkönen.
Kimi Räikkönen.
Können wir reinkommen, heißt es.
Schnelle Fahrer.
Yeah, so explain that to me. I mean, when did you get started?
I started playing when I was 11, because I saw someone on TV playing guitar. And I think it was a Finnish guitar player called Jukka Tolonen. And he's a close friend of Kimi Räikkönen. And I don't remember what song he played, but he had long hair and he was playing a Gibson guitar. And I just thought it looked cool. And my mother and father had a kind of a musical room or a party room. And they had Party Hits Volume 1 to 5. And there was like Roxy Music, let's work together, and all these songs, and I got the rhythm. First guitar I had was from cardboard, and I put like just some strings on, no sound, but it looked great in the mirror. Kimi Räikkönen, thank you very much. Interviews, but the album, as good album should be, was all the music was recorded in 2 days. The last album I did before that, we did in 3 days, so the next album I do will be a live album. But okay, how about we're gonna play a song for my new album. It's a song called Life Living in You. It's in Finland we call this style of music räntätäntä. Olen samaa mieltä, perkele.
Whatever key you like, as long as you tell me.
No, I won't tell you.